tourism right now. You can go to the next slide, please. So first we start with a statewide overview in 2000, and I'm giving you basically 2018 numbers because every year the Wisconsin State Department of Tourism hires a third-party research company to do research on the economy of tourism, and we don't get those numbers in until the May after. So in 2019, in May, we finally get to see the last year, and then we have to use all the trends from the past years also to look at going forward. So in 2018, Wisconsin had over 112 million visitors to the state. The economy of tourism is worth $13.3 billion in visitor spending across 72 counties. That is a plus 5% increase and the largest increase since 2014. The most notable increase is in money spent toward recreation, and that's outdoor recreation. $1.9 billion was captured, and that was the highest gross overall, highest growth rate at 8.4%, more than hotel, spending on hotel or food and beverage or any other type of entertainment. Next slide, please. So this is where Sheboygan County ranks. We're 15th in the state. Sheboygan County has visitor spending at about $240 million per year. That's the highest growth rate ever, and among all of the top 15 states at 7.64%. Next slide, please. So along the lakeshore, Sheboygan County ranks fourth. And since 2011, we've had a $59.9 million increase in visitor spending into the county. Next slide. Now we drill down a little farther. Across the county, you can see that Sheboygan County represents about 42% of room tax collected. The other municipalities that collect room tax rank in Destination Kohler, which captures about 37%, Elkhart Lake, Plymouth, and then Sheboygan Falls Tourism. And those are the areas that capture, actually collect room tax in the county. Next slide, please. So the Sheboygan Area Tourism Zone consists of the City of Sheboygan, the Town of Sheboygan, and the Town of Wilson. And in 2019, we projected that it would capture about $1.1 million in room tax when we did the projections. But we are actually on track to go past $1.2 million. So it looks like we'll be surpassing the estimates. Next slide, please. And this is just a different way to look at basically how we rank. And this is room tax collected in the tourism zone since 2010 and what we're projecting through 2020. You can see by next year we're looking at $1.4 million. Next slide, please. And just one more visual for you to show how the increase looks when we chart it out. Next slide, please. So I'm sure a lot of you have seen the new building going up on 8th Street at the bridge across from Superior Liquor. And this will be the new visitor center that's going in. It's not a building that we'll own. We're actually a tenant there. It's a partnership that we're doing in conjunction with Leslie Kohler's personal development business. In the visitor center will be located the new offices for the Sheboygan staff. Obviously, tons of tourism information, a whole gallery and lobby area committed to the guest experience. There'll be a film viewing area with videos and films that we're shooting around the city and in the tourism zone to show all of the different sites and attractions to visit. There'll be exhibit installation for some hands-on experiences, a gift and souvenir shop, free on-site parking so visitors could actually park their vehicle there for the day and go experience the tourism area. We're planning on having the bike share program there and a trolley stop. Next slide, please. But for a new experience, we're calling this Full Steam Ahead. Our research has shown that eco and environmental hands-on experiences are trending very, very high right now, which also goes with the actual increase in outdoor recreational experiences. So a Science on the Sphere will also be in the building. Not sure if you're familiar with that. When it was at Spaceport, it's owned by Leslie Kohler. It will go in the new facility. It's a 6-foot globe that projects real live online experiences about what's happening on the planet, such as real-time volcano activity, real-time earthquake activity, how many people across the planet are online at that very moment. This is something that's fed from NOAA. So We'll be installing that in the visitor center. That will probably be on 24 hours a day, so it'll be a nice visual from the street as you drive by there. We're also working on a Science in the Sky project. That's the top picture that you see. That will be self-contained eco-enviro lab that will actually have aquaponics experiments, hydraulics experiments, an edible garden. It will capture like some of the plant life that's in our Lake Michigan beachfront area. So really giving people the experience of the environment, of the area, and how precious the Great Lakes resources are and the shorelines that accompany them. Inside the visitor center, it will also be a classroom and lab. We're partnering with SEAS on this, the Sailing Education Association of Sheboygan. And we'll be holding actually tour groups through there, classes through there with hands-on experiences that even visitors can pop in and take advantage of. We've already been talking to the school district about working with us on some of these activities as well. In the future, we're planning to add a research vessel to the community. This is also in partnership with SEAS. The research vessel will be able to take tour groups out on Lake Michigan, and ROV, remote operated vehicle program, will also accompany that. So we'll actually be able to put robotics or remote operated vehicle robots underwater to look at shipwrecks and take soil experiments, and then bring those back into the center and have some hands-on experience with that. Also along the area, the riverfront area where the visitor center will be built, we'll be looking at partnerships for SUP and kayak rentals for visitors right out of that same space. Next slide, please. That is slotted to open, by the way, in April 2020. So just a little research here. Our target markets right now, basically ecological and education tours, are high in demand, and it's growing every day. This is just a new cultural trend, which I'm sure some of you are quite aware of as you have your daily experiences. But these groups are looking for very rare experiences that educate, share local and inside information that immerses them in the culture, and also kind of a protection of the future. And I think as we look around us, we can all feel that that's a trend growing, especially with the younger generation. Next slide, please. Outdoor recreation is king right now. You can tell from the state's numbers that it's had the most growth in the last year where visitors spend their money. But also just Friday, the Wisconsin State Department of Tourism announced its new position that it is searching for, and that's it for a director of outdoor recreation office that they've just added. So that tells you the type of emphasis the state's putting on it and how important it is in trends. So we'll also be following that lead and focusing on this. Next slide, please. This will just give you, this is a little bit of the state information that we've gotten. Over 146 million Americans, or almost half, basically participate at least once in an outdoor activity. You can see on this slide, it might be hard to see, but about 19% of Americans living in the South Atlantic do, and that is the highest rated area for outdoor activity. But number two is the Pacific region and the East North Central region at 16% each, where Wisconsin is located. So it's a very, very large market here. Next slide, please. This just gives you a little idea on male participation in outdoor activities. The green line is outdoor. Red line is inside, and the blue line is sports, or sports membership or participation. So you can see that outdoor experiences are actually more important when they're a hands-on kind of individualistic experience than any other category for males 21 to 40. Next slide, please. For women, same age group, it comes in a little bit lower, but definitely very high up there, and still worth working towards that market as well. Next slide, please. Just to give you an idea, Visit Sheboygan's mission is to create and market experiences that reflect emerging cultural and social trends at the forefront of next generation travel. So we're always looking at the cutting edge, finding new ways to offer what we have, but in different ways that reflect new cultural and generational travel trends. Next slide, please. So the vision of Visit Sheboygan is to excel as the destination leader of next generation travel. We've been doing pretty well at that, actually, along the lakeshore. Fulfilling desires for a connection to place, environment, local engagement, and innovative adventure. Obviously, as our long-term vision goes forward, we're focusing right on target market with what the new trends in the market are telling us. Next slide, please. So our competitive advantage, and as we look at this, and I know everybody's looking at the economy right now, last year everything looked great, 3 days ago we're going, what's going to happen? But either way, travel to Sheboygan is in a very, very good position, because even in downtimes, as long as we're looking at the right markets and new trends, we are an accessible, affordable, very affordable destination that offers an exceptional opportunity to leverage waterfront recreation and leisure activities. And it's close, contemporary, and adventurous. And these all stay in line with the marketing trends coming out of next generation travel. I'm not sure if you're aware of this, but by 2028, millennial travelers will actually overtake baby boomers in the population. And more than 88% of them travel each year, as opposed to 75% of all Americans. And they're worth about over $220 billion in travel dollars. So that next generation travel focus is really, really important to us. So that's where the focus will be.